Okay, my beautiful friends, here we go. You and me on this beautiful, lovely day because we're together. Wednesday, February 1st, 2023. Just happens to be Fed Day. A revolting, vomitous, disgusting, hideous thing. And we're going to hear what comes out of its mouth later on today. 11 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. You know, look, I hate Fed Day. I really do. I hate the Federal Reserve. No man on this earth, I think, could possibly despise this organization more than I do. Because I understand their plan. I know what they're doing. And so do you. You and I, we're on the same page with regard to this thing, this curse upon the earth, which has got to be eradicated. But unfortunately, it won't be. They are too powerful. They are too strong. Collectively, central banks, they're at their pinnacle of power right now, as a matter of fact. Anyway, with that said, again, you know how it's going to play out. 25 basis points, that's what they're going to raise today. At least that's my opinion. You're entitled to your own as well. I know a lot of you believe it's going to be 50. If it turns out to be 50, and again, I highly doubt this, the market's going to hate it. It's going to hate it. The market wants to hear about sunshine and rainbows, more easy money from the Federal Reserve. Look, inflation is continuing to rise. It's not going to stop. And this whole charade with the Federal Reserve and other central banks raising rates here to somehow miraculously in the future stop or reverse inflation has been nothing but a lie. It's just so twisted here. It's not even meant to slow inflation. It's meant to crush demand. Now, with that said, you already know this. How does the Federal Reserve crush demand? By crushing the consumer, by crushing the economy here. So we got an interesting piece of news this morning. So apparently this private payrolls jobs number came in way worse than expected, way worse. And guess what they're blaming it on? The weather. Oh yes, it has nothing to do with the Federal Reserve. I mean, obviously it is the Federal Reserve because we heard it out of their mouth. Mary Daly, remember what she said? In order for inflation to come down, they have to crush jobs. They have to kill jobs. I said, let's start off with theirs. So the mainstream propaganda, don't take my word for this. Look it up for yourself. CNBC and Bloomberg are blaming this abysmal private payrolls jobs number on the weather. It's the weather. You see, it's always the same. Look here. Look at the weather. It's not the Federal Reserve. It's not what central banks are doing. It's an unbelievable script that every single one of these propaganda ministries are handed because they have to deflect off of the Federal Reserve. No one knows this better than you do if you've been following this blog here. It's an incredible thing. So private sector jobs growth craters much lower than expected, and it's being blamed on the freaking weather. Imagine my shock here. You know, I want to bring this up real quick before we touch back on the market. So Michael Burry, you know, the Big Short guy, he's telling everyone to get out of the market right now. He is, I guess, assuming or making a prediction that the stock market is about to drop significantly and immediately. I'm going to say he's wrong. I think the guy is very smart. His call with regard to the subprime, charade that was played on the people. Could you imagine how they did this? These rating agencies kept their AAA ratings on bonds that they knew were worthless. They knew they were worthless. But that's just the game. That's the way it's been playing. So anyway, so Michael Burry is telling people to get out of the market. But I'm going to tell you no. I'm going to tell you to buy this market, get long this market, because the tools that we have, that I use, watching the relative strength of the dollar, which is weaker this morning, watching the 10-year yield, global bond yields, which are lower this morning, watching crude oil coming up the back door here, the unholy trinity here, well, they're pointing towards a market that's going higher. And that doesn't mean it's going to go higher today. The trajectory is higher. I've been telling you this since the end of last year, before this miraculous run here in January. Miraculous because it's central banks buying it all, buying all the debt, buying more debt, buying the stock market as well. Yes, they do buy the market here. According to the MMRI, which dropped this morning, 219, last time I looked at it, again, free to everyone, link in the description of this video. Well, it says that although risk remains extremely, well, not extremely high, very high, extreme risk is over 300, according to the MMRI. This market, to me, again, gauging from the illusion of stability in the debt market, relative strength of the dollar weak, crude oil coming up the back door, you got a market that's setting up to move higher here, people. And I want us to take advantage of this. I want us to take advantage of this like you can't possibly believe. Again, look, I know the market's not for everyone. I get it. But what should obviously be, you should be doing is betting against the debt, becoming your own central bank. These have been my, I think, number one place to be or call since I started this over a decade ago. And you bet against the debt, become your own central bank. How? For you new people here, I'm going to tell you this. Holding a hard asset, gold and silver. Silver, my favorite asset of all time. Why? Please, people, do a little homework here. Look at the Dow Jones Industrial Average gold ratio, gold silver ratio. If you look at these ratios here, you can see why I will never, at least for, that I can possibly imagine, ever deviate from saying that silver is the most undervalued asset on the planet Earth, in my view. And I think it's just a matter of time, again, when this risk-on environment, meaning cash going into the stock market, does flip over. So Michael Burry is correct in one respect, that this market is going to roll over so hard and so fast at one particular point, people's heads are going to spin around like the freaking Exorcist. You all know that. But we don't have to guess. We don't have to guess because we know what we're looking at. The MMRI, debt market as a whole, more specifically 10-year yield, relative strength of the dollar. That's it. That gives us all the information that we need. So, yes, it's going to happen, and it's going to happen in a big way. There's no doubt in my mind, and I'm sure yours, that we are going to face a moment here, a meltdown in the global stock markets that's going to make every single crash before it look like child's play. Why is that? Because the Federal Reserve, along with other central banks, have created distortions across the spectrum of asset classes. The price action here that is so off the Richter scale, it makes no sense. Again, and also looking at the detachment from reality, economy continues to free fall, market going higher. This gap is going to close at one point. Economy, market, it's going to close. And it's going to close like you have no idea how fast it's going to close. But we have to be ready for that. Honestly, that's why I can't imagine us being in better spots here by becoming our own central banks, by having exposure to the long end of this market for now, and even having some cryptocurrencies in your portfolio. In my live stream, I believe it was yesterday or the day before, I did explain to people, I do own some Bitcoin now, not much, like a couple of $1,000 worth. That's it. I bought it around $17,000. I do plan on buying more of this stuff here. Yeah, at one point, I owned a ton of different cryptos. I've kind of consolidated that. I got out of it, as you know, for a little while. Looking to get back in here. And again, I'm not saying that these are the end all and, you know, the alpha and the omega here, people. I'm just saying you need some exposure to this stuff. You got to be diversified. I don't know another way to put it. I've been telling you this for the longest time. Anyway, on the economic front, I do want to touch back on the market. Bear with me here. So as you all know, manufacturing here in the United States, factory activity, they're calling it a manufacturing and factory recession. That's not Greg Mannarino. That's what they're saying here. We're in contraction with regard to that. Now, we found out this morning that, and I already told you this, this is a global phenomenon, but now we have, this is being reported by Reuters, it's their front page. Manufacturing, of course, Europe and Asia continues to contract. Imagine my surprise here. No one could possibly imagine my surprise. You know, going back to this private payrolls jobs number, there's more to it. I want to explain this to you. Not only did it miss the mark here, but higher paying jobs in the private sector are gone. There are none. Any jobs out there are very low paying. And this is exactly, plays right into what you know is happening here. This environment, being it's metastasizing into some kind of a system designed to wipe out an entire class of people. And this is the central banks. This is the Federal Reserve. Think about what they're going to do today. This should aggravate you because it aggravates me. Central banks around the world, and we're going to get it from the Fed, instead of choosing, which they can do, to contract the money supply and actually reduce inflation, they're not doing that. They can do this easily by requiring financial institutions to increase their capital reserve requirements. Not going to happen. You know this already. Why? Because central banks want to continue to inflate. But instead, what they're doing, and this is what gets to me and makes me freak out, is they are now, today, and they've been doing this for a while, charging more for the debt that they issue. Where's the outcry? Where's our loving, caring representatives? We have no representation anymore. People, we need a revolution in this country. We need a revolution in this country. I don't know another way to put it. And there's not going to be one. But look outside. Do you see any marchers in the street? Do you see any people up in arms? No, nothing. They've been dumbed down. They've been I don't know, kind of led into some kind of a state of learned helplessness, and they feel like they can't do anything about it. They have no fight in them anymore, people. It's pathetic. It really, really, really is. Anyway, so stock futures this morning are lower. They're under some pressure after yesterday's rally. Imagine my surprise here. I'm looking at my new trading system I got set up here, and I'm working on this, and I want to tell you, the feedback I'm getting is pretty overwhelmingly positive, and I'm also getting a lot of collaboration with this. And I want to thank all of you that have written to me about this. Hey, Greg, try this and try that. I'm in the middle of perfecting this system, and I'm going to put a lot of time and effort into it. And I'm going to release it all for free to all of you in my free newsletter. I hope you take advantage of that. Anyway, so with that said, people, that's where we stand right now. Futures lower. Silver under some pressure, gold relatively flat, Bitcoin over 23,000, crude oil getting bid higher, MMRI lower. Okay, that's just lovely and beautiful. Let's see how this plays out. So I guess it's let's see if Michael Burry is correct. He's saying we are in for an imminent and bad market meltdown. I say he's wrong, based upon looking at the debt market. You and I have the tools we need to make sense of this entire freaking freak show, honestly. People, today is the first of the month. And the first of every month, I ask for your support. Please support my work. $5. That's all I ask for. What comes out to pennies per day. This includes, all my work, including my all this stuff for free on my website, my free chat room, my free newsletter, these blogs, and everything else I try to do for all of you. So I hope you have my back. I got your back. I hope you have mine. If you choose to support my work, and this is completely voluntary, there is a link in the description of this video. Or if you are a member of YouTube, or I think if you have a Google account, there's a heart down here somewhere. It says thanks. Click on that heart. Like I say, $5. All I ask for. I don't think it's anything extravagant here. We got to support each other. We got to pay it forward. This is now it's your opportunity to pay it forward. All right, people, look, love you a lot. Please share the video. I'll see all of you for my midday live market report at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. All right, with that said, I'll see all of you well later.